This is called what to say gap 1. This is called what to say gap 2. Next. Now at the bottom of the two metal strips, right, this is called A, this is called B. Between the A, B points, let us connect a constant wire. This is called constant wire. This constant wire, right, what to say, of 1 meter. Why we are taking the constant wire? Right? Constantin, the name itself. Copper, nickel, stannous. Right? What is the peculiarity of the constantin wire? It is an alloy whose coefficient of temperature, coefficient of resistivity is very less. For the constantin wire, temperature coefficient of resistance is very less. That means even if you increase to a higher temperature, the resistance of the constantin wire is not going to be changed. Right? In the meter bridge, we are using, right, a wire of 1 meter length made of constantin. Why we are using the constantin? Constantin alpha value is too less. Constantin alpha value is very, very less. What is alpha? Temperature coefficient of resistance. Temperature coefficient of resistance is very less. That means as you increase to a higher temperature, the resistance change is almost all negligible. The resistance is going to be constant. Therefore, that's why we are using a constantin wire. Right, parallel to the constantin wire. Right, now a scale is also kept. Meter scale is kept. This is called what to say, meter scale. Now that is 1, 2, 3 meter scale divisions are like this, right? 100 centimeters are there. 100 centimeters are there. Right? Now, here between the, across the L1 and L2, by providing the L3 flat metal strips, we are going to create G1 and J2. In the G1, in the first gap, there is a resistance box. In the first gap, there is a resistance box. This is the resistance box. Right? The resistance box. Right? In the second gap, you want to substitute. You want to connect an unknown wire is like this. This is called unknown wire of resistance X. In the first gap, you want to connect a resistance box. In the resistance box, you may keep 5000 ohm, you may keep 10,000 ohm, you may keep 15,000 ohm. Therefore, you want to fix a particular resistance. What is the resistance value? Here, R is the resistance value. In the first gap, you want to keep a resistance box which contains a particular resistance of R. In the second gap, you want to keep a specimen whose resistance is to be calculated, whose resistivity is to be calculated in the gap 2. And next one, right across the AB, right across the AB, right, a battery. This is called what to say, battery. This is a battery, and there is a key K, and next one is connected to like this, right? Next one, that is, there is a AB. Next, at the midpoint of the flat metal strip, right, this is called flat metal strip. And from the midpoint of the flat metal strip, right, midpoint of the flat metal strip, there is a wire. There is a wire. That wire is above, right? Is above, like this, right? Like this. Here, there is a high resistance box. What to say? This is called high resistance box. And there is a, what to say? Galvanometer. Galvanometer. This is the galvanometer. And what to say? There is a jockey. This is the jockey. Right? This is the jockey. This is the jockey. The jockey is connected like this. Now, once again, the two L-shaped metal strips are arranged oppositely on the wooden box, second one. Therefore, L3 is the flat metal strip which is placed between L1 and L2 in order to create the two gaps G1 and G2. In the first gap G1, there is a resistance box in which a particular resistance R is maintained according to convenience. In the second gap, right, you want to keep a specimen whose resistance is to be calculated. Next, between A and B, battery B, and key K, both are connected in series. Now, from the midpoint of the metal strip, C, and high resistance box, galvanometer, and jockey, these three are connected in series. Now, the jockey is able to slide along the wire. Now, the jockey may be placed here, the jockey may be placed here, or the jockey may be placed here to complete the circuit. Now, let us consider how it works. Whether the given circuit is right or wrong. Whether given circuit is right or wrong means, if the jockey is connected at A point, now suppose the galvanometer deflection is left, let us consider, right? If the same jockey is connected at the B point, right, the galvanometer shows an opposite deflection. Whether the meter bridge circuits are right or wrong to check. Now the jockey is placed at the A and B simultaneously. If the galvanometer shows opposite deflections, then the circuit is said to be correctly connected. Now next one. Here, how the current is distributed like this. Now, here there is a current I. I current reaches here. Some of the current is passing like this. Okay? Therefore, here, whatever the current reaches the C point, once again the current is going to be distributed. It is some of the current and some of the current is passing through the galvanometer. Now the current is coming like this. Both are combined, reach here. Now remaining current is passing like this and both are combined to pass and reaches the negative terminal. Now whatever the current coming from the battery here.